So CM Punk was mentioned this week by Nick Khan. I don't know if you got a chance to see
that. Yes, I did. I saw the quote. Yeah.
Mark Raimondi flat out asked Nick Khan about CM Punk potentially returning to WWE now that he's not with AEW anymore. And Khan danced around the yes or no answer and saying, listen, we only have respect for Phil. We appreciate his run here. We appreciate what he did and tried to do with the UFC. Not many people can actually get in there and do what he did. So when we have respect for Phil, we wish him nothing but the best. And obviously this is on the heels of him getting fired from AEW with cause over the incident between himself and Jungle Boy. And obviously for people that, you know, need a refresher, Punk and WWE haven't exactly seen eye to eye. But there's a couple of other thoughts behind this too. It wasn't that long ago that Punk here in Chicago went to go visit everybody in the back and I think it was just a random Raw. I don't think it was anything. Well, I mean, a Raw is a Raw, but he was there. He met people in the back. He supposedly talked directly with Miz for a little bit and spoke with Triple H until ultimately Vince said, hey, look, kid, you got to go. And there's been speculation ever since if CM Punk was ever making the decision to kind of come back to WWE. But now with what Nick Khan said, is Nick Khan just kind of giving us the apolitical answer to try and cover up any idea of CM Punk joining with WWE? Or do you think this was his heartfelt way of saying, look, we like Phil, we like CM Punk, but he doesn't fit for our product?
I think that's in a roundabout way. That's what he was. What a cryptic way, as we like to say now. Everybody's so cryptic in the wrestling community with their posts and things they say. You think you know what he's saying, and then he's saying something else, or he can always turn around and go, I never said that. So being cryptic is the new thing.
Right.
Cryptic is the new passive aggressive mission. I don't know really what he's saying, because people are like, well, there it is. CM Punk has no place in current WWE, or there's still hope. That's what I saw, a divisiveness between people talking about it, of what they took from that. What I took from it is, at this particular time, I think it's a no-go. But things can change, and you never say never. If you asked them 10 years ago, any chance Ultimate Warrior is going in the Hall of Fame? That is just too much there between us. A year later, Triple H has him in the Hall of Fame. So you never say never. I it's not even cliche to say that phrase. It's true. And especially in wrestling, wrestling is shock and surprise. And that's actually, I think, the great part about wrestling. If CM Punk's music hits at the Royal Rumble, people will lose their fucking minds. Mm-hmm. And it'll be, and I'll even, you know, even if you're a detractor of his, you'll be like, son of a bitch, he's here. Oh my God. Like, you can imagine how in the Royal Rumble, that fucking social media would catch fire. That Living Color music hits.
Oh,
yeah. Again, and honestly, as time goes by, people lessen on their disdain for people, or sometimes it strengthens. But when you're going, you know, let people miss him for a while. If I was CM Punk, I would lay low for a little while, maybe make a statement eventually. And if he's going to come to WWE, Rumble or Mania would be the time to do it.
Well,
I don't see him this year at all being anywhere this year.
So here's the other part of this too, where some people don't really know what's going on with AEW and their contracts. First off, it was kind of alluded that the NDA is a misnomer, because if they fired you, they can't force you to come back and sign an NDA. So the idea that CM Punk might be able to unleash somewhere could potentially still be a possibility. Mm-hmm. Second off too, with cause, people are saying, well, he can't sign with another promotion for at least a year. And that's WWE's terms for with cause. We don't know how AEW contracts work with cause. So I'm very curious to see if they had a similar contract to WWE where Phil can't work anywhere in any promotion for a year, or if Tony Khan and the AEW contracts don't necessarily have something like that. And with that stated too, Survivor Series is here in Chicago, right up the block.
That's right.
And with everything as hot as it is, and I know you were saying, you know, Mania or Royal Rumble, absolutely. But if you want that Chicago element, Survivor Series and having CM Punk come out, once again, if the stars are aligned right and everything is perfect, I mean, that roof will come off the Allstate.
It will. And I'm saying, wrestling fans love to be surprised. I never understand where everybody wants to know how all the magic is made. I want to see how all the magic tricks are done. Even at 55, I still like to be surprised, and I like to even be wrong. I like to even go into it and go, well, I didn't see that coming.
Right.
But where other people like find that to be like a, you know, sign of weakness if they admit that they didn't know that was coming. I love it when I don't see it that coming because I want to be surprised. I don't want to be an expert on 100% of everything. I want to have knowledge and maybe get it right and give myself a Barry Horowitz pat on the back. Oh, I got it right. But if you get it wrong, I think it's just as much fun because you didn't see it coming. And same thing with when Jey Uso came out as a solo star. I didn't see anybody call that, including Meltzer 2 weeks ago, that Jey's going to be pushed as a solo guy in Raw. It was a nice little surprise. So I still like the surprise. And if CM Punk's music hits, I'll probably be one of those guys who'll be posting, holy shit, I can't believe he's here.
It would be amazing. It would actually be fucking amazing. And I would like to think that CM Punk and WWE have kind of mended fences. You know, I mean, there's a lot of reasons that, you know, Phil and AJ could be pissed off at WWE still to this day, but you'd like to think that Triple H and Vince and CM Punk and AJ Lee have all sat around and talked about the situation and maybe cleared some things up. I mean, that was one of the things that people gave credence to Triple H on, you know, and you even just said it just now with the Ultimate Warrior thing and Bruno Sammartino being another one.
Guys, Randy Savage being inducted.
Yeah, not wanting anything to do with WWE ever again, not wanting to deal with Vince. And Triple H has supposedly been the guy to kind of like mend some of these fences and shake these hands and get people to come back. So you would think, you know, a guy like CM Punk is absolutely somebody that you apologize to and maybe find a way to bring it back on board.
Follow WrestleSoup on Twitter at WrestlingSoup. Like and subscribe to WrestlingSoup on YouTube. And check out the Discord for live chat during the shows at discord.gg/WrestlingSoup. Check out and subscribe to the shows on Apple, Amazon, iHeartRadio, Spotify,
and more.